Hey, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to be looking at another unsupported MacBook Pro run in Ventura. This time we're checking out the 2015 15-inch MacBook Pro. This one has a Core i7 processor, 16 gigs of RAM, and the AMD Radeon R9 M370X dedicated GPU. We're going to talk about how it performs, some of the things that work and don't work, one really goofy thing that Apple did that I'll talk about a little bit later in the video. There is supposedly a way to get around this. I haven't gotten it to work, but I'll talk about that more. And then I'll tell you whether I think you should upgrade or not upgrade. You shouldn't upgrade. So let's just get into this video and talk about the regular performance. Now, before I get into that, actually, I want to mention that I upgraded this MacBook Pro using OpenCore Legacy Boot Patcher because the 2015 MacBook Pro is not officially supported on Ventura. If you want more information about how I did that, I'll put a link up in the corner here. It's a tutorial video I did. It's using a 2012 MacBook Pro, but the process is exactly the same for this one. So if you want to go for this upgrade, just follow that tutorial and it'll get you going. So talking about the hardware, everything is recognized and works great. Keyboard, trackpad, all the ports, the HDMI port, the card reader, the camera, everything works as you would expect and works with all the software just as if it was a supported MacBook. Performance, day-to-day performance, just using this like you normally would, browsing the web, doing word processing, all that kind of stuff. It tears through all that stuff, absolutely no problem. For a long time, this was a really sought after computer because it's the last one that had all the ports before they switched to just doing the USB-C. Now, of course, MacBook Pros are coming out with the ports again for some of the M1 and M2 MacBook Pros. But for a long time, this 2015 MacBook Pro was the last one that you could get with these ports, and it still performs great today. Moving beyond the day-to-day stuff, a little more advanced stuff like 3D rendering or video creation using Final Cut Pro or DaVinci Resolve, those all work great. Now, the fans do spin up and the fans are pretty loud on this computer, but this isn't a review of the computer. It's how Ventura works, and all these apps work great in Ventura on this computer. Now, there are some macOS specific features. Some of these were released for Ventura and some are older. So I just want to go through some of those. The first thing is Stage Manager. That's a new thing and it works great. Absolutely fine. You can open the multiple applications, create the groupings, all that kind of stuff works fantastic on this computer. No issues at all. Another thing that works as expected is AirDrop. No problem there. Recognizes all the devices. You can send stuff to and from the Mac. That's not a big deal. AirDrop's been around forever and it works fine using Ventura on this unsupported Mac. Another thing that works, I don't usually talk about this, but a lot of people ask, yes, you can use Bootcamp on this. I have Windows 10 installed with macOS on here. Now, the caveat to that is that when you're installing OpenCore Legacy Patcher, you have to leave the boot menu on. There's a checkbox to turn it off, but you need to leave that on or else you might get stuck into a situation where you can't boot back into macOS without having a USB stick. So let's talk about some of the things that don't work. And the first thing is Continuity Camera. Now, this is a functionality that lets you use your iPhone as a camera for macOS. And yeah, that doesn't work on here. It's just like with the 2012 MacBook Pro run in Ventura. Sometimes you'll see the phone show up as a device, but you go and select it. Even though the phone is showing that it's connected to the computer, you never see any of the video on the computer. So that is not usable. The next thing I want to talk about that doesn't work is universal control. This is the ability to be able to use your trackpad and keyboard on your MacBook Pro and control your iPad with it just by kind of dragging over, or use the iPad keyboard and mouse and control your MacBook Pro or your other Macs, whatever. It doesn't work. And the goofy thing is, this is kind of what I mentioned earlier, this computer is fully capable of doing that. You can even do that on the 2012 MacBook Pro using OpenCore Legacy Patcher, installing Ventura, and that works. But it will not work on this, and that's because Apple blacklisted these computers. So no matter what hackery you do, it's not gonna work unless you spoof the system ID. So what that means is you have to go through this process of making the system think that it's a different computer than it is, like a 2016 MacBook Pro. That's a super goofy process, and I have not been able to get it to work on this. I followed a couple tutorials, even the one directly from the OpenCore Legacy Patcher site, and every time I try to enable that, I get it to where I cannot boot the system. It breaks the system boot, and then if I boot off a USB and reset that setting, I'm able to get right back in. So I haven't gotten that to work. If I do get it to work, I'll do a video, just a quick one, just on that, on how to set that up. But yeah, I've had no luck with that. So if you had, can you just let me know down in the description what you did to get that working, like what tutorial you followed? Even if it's another YouTuber that you followed their video, just let me know what that is. I'm really curious how you got that working. So the other stuff that's new in Ventura, like the weather app and all that kind of stuff, that stuff works fine because that's just software. And it's really a shame that they kind of crippled this computer and blacklisted it. And the only thing I can guess is that because this was so desirable, people weren't buying the newer MacBook Pros. So they blacklisted this one to kind of encourage people to upgrade, which really sucks in my opinion. But that's the only reason I can think that they would do that, because hardware wise, it's perfectly capable. So that's all I really have to say about Ventura running on this computer. Just general use, it works great. Some of those extra features don't work. So now we have the question of whether you should upgrade or not. And yeah, just don't. Just stay on Monterey. Upgrading to Ventura really doesn't get you anything unless you need Stage Manager. If you love Stage Manager, you need it as part of your workflow, by all means, use OpenCore Legacy Patcher. Follow that tutorial I pointed out. Upgrade it. It's a relatively easy process. But otherwise, I would say just stay on Monterey. It's officially supported on the 2015 MacBook Pro. It works great. You won't have any issues with the latest software. Everything is still supported. There's just no point in going through the effort of upgrading to Ventura on this computer. Now, hopefully you found this useful or informative. If you have any questions, leave those down in the comment section below. If you really like this video, please consider subscribing or at least hit that thumbs up, and I will see you in the next video.